All right, so we made it to chapter 12, and we are going to work on angles and degree measures. So I got to be honest, I really love this part of Algebra 2, so hopefully you guys will kind of like it as well. So in Algebra 2, when we talk about angles, every angle will have two sides. The initial side is going to be the side where the angle starts. So you can see we have two pictures here. This is the initial side. We call the other side a terminal side. It's where the angle terminates. So initial side, terminal side. A counterclockwise rotation yields a positive angle. So let's say that this is my initial side of my angle. And then counterclockwise means that I'm going to go this way. Let's say I go that far. Here's my terminal side. That is a positive 90 degree angle. A clockwise rotation yields a negative angle. So what we're saying there is if this is my angle, this is my initial side. If I go clockwise this way, let's say to this position right there, that is going to be a negative 90 degree angle. So now that we're in Algebra 2, we have positive angles and we have negative angles. So how do you know if it's a positive or negative angle? We look for this little part of it, this little part that shows us which direction the angle was going. Did it go counterclockwise? That's positive. Did it go clockwise? That is negative. Standard position is when an angle's initial side coincides with the x-axis. So we're going to see a lot of drawing of angles with the x and y axis. So I might say, okay, here's my x and y axis. And then my initial side is right here on the x axis. And let's say we have a positive angle. So maybe over to here, there's the terminal side. That's a positive 135 degree angle. So standard position is when the initial side is on the x-axis like that. Angles can be classified according to the quadrant in which their terminal side lies. So you can see this angle right here. Here's the initial side. It's a positive angle because we went counterclockwise, and the terminal side is in the second quadrant, so that is a second quadrant angle. This next example, we have our initial side. Our terminal side is in quadrant 1, so that's a first quadrant angle. And what do you call an angle that doesn't land or the terminal side is not actually in one of the quadrants? If you have the angle that ends on one of the axes, we call that a quadrant angle. So this would be 90 degrees up there. I could go another 90 degrees. Maybe I would have an angle land over here, maybe from here to here. That would be a 180 degree angle. Maybe I would have an angle that would go all the way over to this. That's another quadrant angle. That would be 270 degrees. And what do you guys think it would be if we had an angle that went all the way over back to where we started? That would be a 360 degree angle. Which takes us to our next point. A full revolution, which means one full circle around, is 360 degrees. And then we have these things called coterminal angles. So let's just draw in an example of some coterminal angles. So here's my x and y axis. Here's my initial side of my angle. So I'll just kind of do an easy example. Let's say I go here and my angle lands there. That's a 90 degree angle. Well, let's say I have another angle that starts on the same initial side, and it's not positive, but I go down. Here's a negative 90, negative 180, negative 270. So that's a negative 270 degree angle, But they're called coterminal angles because the terminal side of each angle is in the same position. So one was 90, one was negative 270. Those are coterminal angles. And you can find coterminal angles by adding and subtracting 360 degrees. So we had 90 degrees first. If I subtract 360 degrees, what that's doing is it's taking me around a full rotation and landing in the same spot, but it is giving me a different angle of negative 270 degrees. So coterminal angles are angles that land in the same spot. All right, so we're just going to practice sketching some angles and kind of getting familiar with where these angles are in our graphs and our x and y axes. So there's my coordinate plane, 45 degrees. Well, I know from here to here is 90 degrees, so it's going to be half of that. So I'm going to go ahead and draw halfway there, and so from here to here. A lot of times what you'll see, if you guys notice, I actually didn't draw in the initial side here, but this little arrow guy here tells me that I started here, I landed here, there's my 45 degree angle. So it's assumed that this is the initial side. Maybe I should just go ahead and draw in, but I understand if that is not drawn in as well. Classify by quadrant. This is a first quadrant angle. All right, well, now we get a fun one, 480 degrees. So we notice that this is positive. So which direction do we go for a positive angle? We're going to go, and this is your initial side. We always start with this positive x-axis right here. So we're going to go up, and I'm going to kind of follow along. So here is 90 degrees, 180, 270, 360. And do you see what I'm going to end up doing is going around and around however many times it takes to get to 480. So we are at 360 degrees. If I go another 90, it gets me to 450. So I'm at 450 degrees. I need 480. So I'm going to go 30 more degrees into the second quadrant. Draw in my angle. Draw my little arrow there so I can see that was the direction I was going. So we have 360 degrees, one full rotation, and then 90, and then 30 degrees more. And you can tell that this is 30 degrees into this quadrant, because if you were to take this quadrant and divide it into thirds, that is approximately where that would be. And that is a second quadrant angle. Are you guys enjoying this yet as much as I am? I love this stuff. This is fun. All right, so what's going to be different about this one? Well, it's a negative 120 degree angle. So that means instead of going up, we are going to go down. So we go down first. This gets us to negative 90. And then we have to go how many more to get to the negative 120? Just 30 more degrees into this quadrant. So again, I'm kind of looking at going into this quadrant just a third of the way. And I'm going to draw my little arrow guy there so I can see the direction of the angle. So I went negative, so I went down 90 and another 30 degrees. There's my negative 120 degrees. That is the third quadrant, so that's a third quadrant angle. And last, but certainly not least, negative 405 degrees. So negative means I'm going to go down. And do you see how it's more than 360? So I'm going to go all the way around one full rotation. That's a negative 360 degrees. So we're at negative 360. How many more do we need to go to get to negative 405? Well, that's another 45 degrees. So I have to go 45 degrees into this quadrant, which means I'm going to go halfway in. So halfway in, draw your angle. That got a little sloppy right there. Maybe I'll do that one a little bit better. There we go. Don't forget the little arrow on that to show the direction. And that is a negative 405 degree angle. That is the fourth quadrant. So a fourth quadrant angle. All right, for this chapter of Name That Tune, I thought I'd take you back to high school and play for you guys the most popular songs back in the day when I was going through high school like you guys are. So this was the most popular song back in my freshman year, maybe eighth grade a little bit. I can't remember what time of the year it came out.